Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. I have good news for you. You do not have to hand draw neon elements from scratch in After Effects. You can use this new pack that my friends over at Smashworks created. It's a pack of MOGRT neon elements that includes transitions, lightning bolts, zigzags, swirly things, all sorts of things that you can layer and place on top of your video footage to give it that extra pop. So if you have a dancer, a basketball player, a race car, you can add these elements just to add some more dynamism. You can customize them, change the color, alter them. I'm going to show you how I did all of this with the opening sequence that you saw with the skateboarder, and you'll walk away knowing how to use them correctly on your own footage. So if you're interested in trying out the Smashworks pack, I have a link just down below. It's my affiliate link. So if you use that link, it helps support the channel. I also have a discount code 10% off down below. Without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere and I'll show you how it works. So right now we're looking at the final sequence in my timeline with all the neon elements layered. All of the rose clips here, these are the neon mogrts that I've placed over top the sequence. Of course, without the elements, the sequence is good with sound effects, but the neon elements just provide a bit more visual candy. So let me show you how they work and how I added them, starting with a clean timeline with just the videos. So first you're going to go over to the Essential Graphics panel. If you don't see the Essential Graphics panel, you can go up to Window, Essential Graphics, and if you don't have it at all, it means you need to upgrade to a newer version of Premiere Pro. Then you can press the plus icon in the lower right to import the MOGRT files. If you have multiple MOGRTs like we do in this pack, you can select all of the MOGRTs by pressing Shift and then drag and drop them directly into your Essential Graphics panel and they will import. So I already have them imported here and you can search for them just by typing in neon and they will show up. And they will live here forever. But if you work on multiple devices, I recommend adding them to your library, and this is how you do that. You can right-click on any MOGRT here, and you can copy it to your library, so that way you can access the MOGRTs from any computer using your Creative Cloud library, and you would just filter by library. So first, I'm going to show you how I applied one of the zigzag elements. The zigzag elements is part of the neon elements one, so I'm going to drag this MOGRT on top of the shot here. I'm going to first right-click on this MOGRT to scale it to frame size because my timeline is 1080p and the MOGRT is 4K. So you can see first, it shows you a preview of all of the different elements that are within this one MOGRT. And when you go over to Essential Graphics, the first thing you can do is use this slider to change it to the zigzag element that you want. So we can move this slider over and you can see that between 21 and 25, are the zigzags. So I'm going to move the slider to number 24, which is the one that I used in this case. Then I'm going to zoom into the timeline to better see it, and I'll move the MOGRT over to align with the video clip as well. As I preview it, I want it to align better with the cutting here, so I'm going to use the rotation slider to rotate it. Then I'll use the up and down slider to bring it down slightly. Then I can preview it back, and I can see that I want to move it over to the left a bit so it starts earlier on the left of the frame. And if you need to make the MOGRT flip, you can click here on horizontal flip. And down here at the bottom, we can play around with the glow controls. We can increase the glow intensity and the glow size. So after you increase the intensity, you'll notice that there's kind of a darker ring around the MOGRT zigzag. To get rid of that, we actually need to change the blend mode to screen. And the blend mode screen will actually remove all of the black from this particular shot. Next, we can press C to cut here, so that way the MOGRT clip ends exactly when the animation ends, and then select the excess and press delete. Then I'm going to duplicate the zigzag again by holding the Option Alt key, and then you drag it up and you let go, and it will create a duplicate. Then I'm going to use the controls over here to slightly change the position so that way they're not stacked exactly on top of each other. And then I will change the color to yellow. And then I will enable the custom glow control and adjust the glow color. So now to preview this, I'm just going to press I and then move over and press O to create this in and out point. That way I can press enter and it will render it out so I can quickly preview how it looks. So that's how you stack and duplicate the neon elements, but what if you want to apply one of their hand-painted neon transitions? Let's show you how these work. So the transition I use between these two shots is the hand-painted neon elements 4, which is included in the neon elements master bundle. So I'm going to drag and drop the MOGRT down into my timeline, and just like before, I'm going to right-click and scale it to frame size. For this, I'm going to type in 14 because it was transition 14 that I chose for this particular shot. And you can see as you scrub through, you can see that the animation outro ends here, but the space between the animation on and the animation out is quite long. And unfortunately, you can't just drag this in to change the speed. We actually have to cut a chunk of it out. So this is how it works. So go to the point where you want to make a cut, and then you can click, and then you can drag the playhead to the part where you want the outro to begin and cut there. And then you can select this middle area and press delete, and then use the selection tool to splice the two endings together. Then we can select both the clips and move it so that way the cut point is aligned at the same cut point between the two video clips below. And you can see that the transition clip is longer than the clip. So this is where we need to actually change the speed of the transition. To do this, we will use the rate stretch tool by pressing R on our keyboard, and you can select the end of this clip and drag it in to speed it up. If we zoom into the clip here, you can see what exact speed we changed it to with the rate stretch tool. It says 207.69%. So now we can do the same thing for the end animation, but instead of using the rate stretch tool, we can actually right click on the clip and select speed and duration and type in the same speed as before, so 207.69, so that way it's the same speed. And then once again, let's set in and out points and press enter to render it out to preview how it looks. And here's the final result. So for this transition, my feedback to the Smashworks team are two things. One, to be able to include an expression when they design this in After Effects, so that way when we roll that MOGRT clip in, it will automatically change the speed. And if there was some sort of control in the MOGRT that we can type in exactly how many seconds we want that filled screen to last for, so we don't have to cut it out manually. But I mean, what I just showed you doesn't take that long to do. It might take just as long to use those controls in the Essential Graphics panel, but it's just a nice to have. And just like the other elements, you can make this transition glow as well. You can increase the intensity and the size, and then go to Effect Controls and change the blend mode to screen. And when we did this, it did make the transition just a little bit transparent, so you can see some of the video beneath. In this case, I think it works, but if you want it to be opaque so you can't see the video beneath, then I wouldn't add the glow for this particular transition. And lastly, for one of the shots, I did rotoscoping. Here you can see that the element is behind the hand. So to do that, all I did was duplicate the video clip. And this right here, the one that I labeled blue, this is the duplicate clip, and the MOGRT is beneath it. So what I did was I right-clicked on this duplicate, and I opened it up in After Effects, and then I used the rotobrush tool to trace out the hand, so that way it would be transparent beneath. And then back here in Premiere, you can see that I placed the MOGRT element beneath the rotoscoped AE comp and the original video on the bottom. So that way, the element looks like it's beneath the hand. So I know rotoscoping can be intimidating, and I just briefly covered it here, but if you want to learn more about how rotoscoping works, how to put text, for example, behind a moving subject, how to remove the subject from the background, you can watch this tutorial right up here. You can click on the card, and it just gives you a look at three different examples of moving shots, so you can rotoscope out the subject and put text behind, so you can watch that. If you want to look at my full timeline to see what exact MOGRTs I placed in the exact same spots, you can sign up to become a patron. On my Patreon community, you can download my project files and templates. I put links down below, and it just gives you a more in-depth look at my tutorials, and you can also access my tutorial editing scripts to get an idea of how everything works here on Premiere Gal. Overall, the best thing about this neon pack is that you don't have to hand draw from scratch. They'll just live inside of your Essential Graphics panel forever, and you can just drag and drop them on top of your video and manipulate them to match the video. And that's exactly what I did. I just went in and just played around until I found the right rhythm with the video and the music, of course. So if you're interested in purchasing the Neon Elements pack, I am a Smashworks partner. I did not design the pack itself, but I am a partner. So if you use my link down below, it helps support the channel and Premiere Gal, and you can use my code GAL10 to get an extra 10% off. And yeah, that's all for today's video. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye. So if you're still watching this video, I also wanted to give a shout out to ArtGrid. All of the footage here is from ArtGrid. I did not shoot it myself. And what's really great about ArtGrid is they have an entire story of different shots. So you can download a bunch of the same shots with the same actor and build your own story from that. And the link is just down below.